I apologize for my appearance. I've misplaced my regular pair of sunglasses. Those dear friends I've been missing the past 48 hours, so if you know or see them, big yellow square ones, see them anywhere, let me know. This is our technical first week of February news. Last week was the Harry Styles birthday special. This week is a Grammy special. That's kind of because that's the only thing that went on this week. But most of all, welcome to the Stan Report. Before we dive into anything musical, let's get our film and TV out of the way and jump into the lounge with Lindsay with an E.
You lost your sunglasses, right, bruh? Yeah, I lost my microphone, dude. I'm using this hammer right now. What's up, dudes? I'm Lindsay with an E. I'm your film bro, and this is The Lounge, where I watch everything and anything. Right now, I'm working through The Last of Us, of course. Abbott Elementary, of course. And I just started watching The Great on Hulu. Really have a deep soft spot for old stuff, I guess. What would they call it? Like 1800s, early 1900s, you know, like the Victorian eras. Like Emily Dickinson, Jane Austen, Pride and Prejudice, like the past, you know? I love it. And so I'm eating The Great absolutely up because it's been leveling out nicely with pieces of modern day. Dickinson on Apple TV, that one does that almost perfectly. If you've seen The Great, let me know what you thought, because so far it's pretty freaking good. Let's see what happened this week in film and TV. I know this is like the weird in-between time between Oscar nominations coming out and the Oscars. Soon enough, it'll be our time to shine. Quinta Brunson, the lady that she plays Janine in Abbott Elementary, but she's also the writer and creator of Abbott Elementary. She was just in Sesame Street, and her and Tyler Jones Williams, who plays Gregory, they'll be playing Hawkman and Hawk Girl in the new Harley Quinn Valentine special on HBO Max, which I'm excited to see. That 90s show, I was just talking about it the other week because I watched it when it came out and I thought it was good, and guess what? It was just renewed for a second season, so my bag is secure with that one. Never know, it's really kind of scary out here nowadays with what's being canceled and what. Florence Pugh got the Best Actress win at the UK Critics Circle Awards for both of her roles in Don't Worry Darling and The Wonder, and I'm always proud of my girl, Miss Florence Pugh. Frankie got Best Young Performance for her role in Aftersun, and that, I do have to say, I'm pretty stoked about, because I thought she was absolutely phenomenal, especially for her first role. Phenomenal. And She's of Ina Sheeran got a lot. Makes sense, because it's probably the best film to come out of the UK this year. Irish and me is so proud of him, dude. Viola Davis is now officially an EGOT. Joins Whoopi Goldberg and Jennifer Hudson as the third black woman to be an EGOT. Yeah, she deserves it. Give her all the flowers, give her all the confetti. Like, Apple TV won't stop giving Timmy ads. I'm not mad about it. I'm not mad about it one bit. If I can see that man on my day-to-day, yeah, give it to me. In the future, whatever Apple TV TV show he has coming in the future, this is like such a stretch of PR. And I'm not mad about it. I wanna know. He's never done TV before. Movie Chevalier, I think it's pronounced Chevalier. Chevalier. It could be any of the three. It's starring Kevin Harrison Jr. and that's coming out April 21st. And that's about Mozart and I guess Chevalier. Genuinely looks really, really freaking good. La La Land is getting a Broadway show, or at least they're in the talks and the works of it. And I think that is brilliant. I will try to get tickets and make it down there, because that makes sense. Like, that's brilliant. Kind of like an opposite. Mean Girls, the Broadway musical, is getting a film. And they just hired Aventika and Chris Brinley to join Renee Rapp. And, oh, I really don't want to mispronounce her name. She played Moana in Moana. You know who I'm talking about. She's phenomenal. She's absolutely amazing. I never remember how to pronounce her name, but she played Moana. There's also rumors that Toy Story 5 is coming. Why they actually come out with Toy Story 5, that would be like the death of Toy Story. That would really, really push it over the limit. Patience is already like boiling over just a little bit because they made a Toy Story 4 when there really didn't need to be a Toy Story 4. And now it's like, okay, you're burning the house down if they make Toy Story 5, which sucks because as a trio, literally some of the best Disney and Pixar movies ever made. They just keep adding more and it's like, enough. We've had our fair share. Give it 30 years. Then they decided to make a Toy Story 5. I'd get that. But like, now? No. And finally, today, Thursday, You, Season 4, Part 1 is out and in London. And the aesthetic is so freaking cool, bro. I watched a season and a half of You, and I think I'm going to have to pick it back up again just because it's calling my name. That's all I have for this week. I'm gonna shoot it over to a pretty sick commercial break.
So this angel. I really saw it.
Let's shoot over to the Twitter hub to see what was happening this week, other than the Grammys.
What's up, guys? I'm Lindsay with the Y. Welcome to my office. Nothing too crazy really happened on Twitter this week. Most of what everybody talked about was the Grammys, which isn't my territory. That's where we draw the lines for these things. I only have like a short, sweet little segment for you guys. First off, this was the most trend-worthy tweet that I found this week. This lady saying, letting yourself age gracefully is far more beautiful than plastic surgery. Here's proof. Madonna at 64, my mom at 64. This exploded a little bit, especially earlier in the week. For many reasons. One, don't shame someone for getting plastic surgery. If someone wants to get plastic surgery, then they want to get plastic surgery. We're all just humans trying to make ourselves be happy. Second, why are you coming at Madonna? And third, there's so many better 64-year-old looking people out there that poor mom got ripped to shreds. An earthquake hit Turkey and Syria. Here's a little thing with just a whole bunch of information on it. I say read up on it, see where you can help any way that you possibly can. Thousands of people are dead and so many people, the way people are reacting to the situation is just horrible. So if you or anyone you know can help whatsoever, please do. It's also not their fault that the world is crumbling and global warming is happening. So we'll all try to get through the end of this world together. A lot of talk about this boot. I love it. I can't even say anything bad about it. I love it. People from all over are trying to style it, which I think would be so fun to do, and also calling it like the cartoon boot, which I think is just so fun. Like, I actually really like something about this boot satisfies my head, and I think we as a collective need to start wearing big, bulky, cartoony type shoes much more often. Netflix was a liar. I know that was something that Lindsay with an A wanted to cover last week before the whole thing happened. Netflix had announced this new anti-password sharing rule on their thing, where every 31 days it has to be logged into the correct Wi-Fi browser or the account would be blocked off of it. Obviously, this struck a lot, because so many situations where you don't have a consistent Wi-Fi. Maybe you have divorced parents and you're using one parent but you live with the other parent, or maybe you're a college student and you're away from home. Maybe you live on the road. Musicians? What would musicians do when they're touring? There's so much wrong with it. And so I was really looking forward to covering that last week. But then the day after posted my video last week, they announced that what they were saying and that whole entire thing was just an error on the website. And everyone was like, okay, sure. You just clearly saw that you yourself is going to plummet because if they uphold this, then they're going to lose so much money, which is insane. Like, why would they do that? And so they were like, oh, it was just an error, it was just an error. And then yesterday, it said Netflix has started rolling out their new anti-password sharing rule in Canada, New Zealand, Portugal, and Spain. So they were lying about lying. How disgusting is that? Young Royals needs to move to a new streaming platform because I'm getting tired of it. Like, and our last story for today, the Super Bowl is coming up. I got my Eagles hat on. Go Eagles! Go Eagles! Go Eagles! Go Eagles! Go Eagles! E-A-G-L-E-S! Eagles! Eagles! All of it. Go Eagles! I even rooted against my team this year to root for the Eagles. Wait, hold on. They're going to the Super Bowl the 1 year that I decide not to root for the Packers? The 1 year that I'm like, no, I'm rooting against the Packers and I'm just putting it full force in the Eagles. They're going to the Super Bowl. Do not... Crap, I might have to like stick. I can't. No, the second the Packers get rid of Aaron Rodgers, I'll be back in the Packers' hands. But till that moment, I got a hometown somewhere, and that hometown is Philadelphia. Rihanna is also performing at the halftime, and this is her return to music today, Thursday. She had her halftime press conference, and she confirmed that her halftime show is 13 minutes long. They had 39 different working set lists making it, and she is working on new music, and she's looking to create something more open and like just looking to create good music. And I'm really, really excited because girl, you left us on anti, and I think that's all I have for today. To join literally everyone else in the studio, I think the full moon is getting to us. I couldn't find my Eagles shirt today, so I do apologize to the Eagles on that one, but I will be rooting for you forever. Fly, Eagles, fly to the road of victory. Yeah, turn it back to Lindsay with an A in the studio.
Thank you, Lindsay. I do have more music news than just the Grammys this week. So hold your horses. This last Friday, it should be out now, Khalid and Dove Cameron came out with a song called We Go Down Together. And I personally am really, really excited for this song because I love both of them. And I'm waiting for Dove to just like take off. She's really on that rise right now. And I'm really excited for her. And I also I love Khalid. He's bestie. Jonas Brothers are coming out with a single called Wings on February 24th. And they also announced they're coming out with their album called The Album. And a lot of people are like, this feels very repetitive or copy. I think people are failing to get that this is the Jonas Brothers' 7th record. This is their 7th album from year 3000. It better be featuring Kelly Clarkson. This is the album. This is the big one. Yes, I think the timing might be poor. I will even give the Jonas Brothers a second chance when it comes to this one. Louis Tomlinson announced that he's having a movie come out, a concert kind of documentary movie. You know how Jane Austen and Emma wrote, if I loved you less, I would talk about you more. That is the only way that I can express how I feel about Louis Tomlinson. Like, I physically cannot talk about him. But he's coming out with a movie. See? He's coming out with a movie called All of Those Voices. And it's coming out March 22nd, and tickets are on sale February 22nd, which is the day before my birthday. And he is the one person in this world that I love more than Harry Styles. So, I will be there. I will be in attendance multiple times. Maybe I'm in the movie. I wouldn't be surprised. Okay. Flowers, Miley Cyrus's hit number one song, is now 27 days on number one. She's now joined Ariana Grande and Taylor Swift as the only female artist in Spotify history to have over 80 million monthly listeners, which is so awesome. And she just found this awesome gap in the music industry right now, and the charts right now with this new year. Everyone just released all their stuff, especially to get nominated for the Grammys, and all this hype is around all these other artists right now because of the Grammys. And Miley like just shot in real quick while everyone was getting situated. Like, now there's more music being announced this up and coming year, but she took everybody. She was like, my year, my year. And I'm really excited. Like, I'm really excited to see what happens and for her album to come out. Billboard and Vibe also made their list of greatest rappers of all time. They named Nicki Minaj the greatest female rapper of all time. And yeah, duh. Like, it does not matter if you like Nicki Minaj or if you hate Nicki Minaj, if you got personal shit against Nicki Minaj, if you are fucking Barb, it does not matter. You know that Nicki Minaj is the number one rapper, female rapper of all time. She has opened so many doorways and pathways and has kept it consistent and kept it I wouldn't even consider myself a Barb. Rarely listen to rap music in the first place, but Nicki, I will be listening to every time because she is the greatest of all time, and that's personal bias on me. I will claim that, but you can't. Oh my God, this has like been falling out. On Thursday, special featuring SZA, Lizzo's song came out, and I thought it was so good, and I love the little cover art, and then everyone's hating on it, and I think it's so fun. So just, I don't know, it felt like a little like post-Grammy surprise because she was just like special featuring SZA and called it a day. That's so fun. I love it. Paramore's album is also coming out Friday. This is why. I'm excited. I'm really excited for it. I will always give Paramore's albums a listen. Oh yeah, the Grammys. Grammys were this week and by God, this leading up to this Grammys, we knew that it was going to be a whole thing. Okay, during lockdown, these artists, the biggest artists in the world and our generations and living today, were writing music. And so this is like the time when they're coming out with that music and getting recognized for this music. So the Grammy nominees this year were literally some of the greatest of all time, like the GOATs, like Taylor Swift, Beyonce, Adele, Lizzo, Harry, Bad Bunny, like literally the greatest with the biggest fandoms, with the biggest everythings. This was the everythings. Sam Smith and Kim Petras won a Grammy this year for their song Unholy, which they also performed, and everyone's like, oh my God, Satan, and I was like, yes! Kim is also the first openly transgender woman to win a Grammy, and I'm pretty sure that makes Sam also in the trans community because they're non-binary, correct? To win a Grammy, like the two of them, power team, I don't know. Taylor Swift won the Grammy for best music video for her 10-minute short film for All Too Well, which I thought was appropriate. Like that was, yeah, that was appropriate. Like she literally made a film. Adele won a Grammy for pop solo performance, which I was happy about. I love Adele. I do love Adele. I love Adele. Adele and I might be in a fight at the moment, but I do love her endlessly and I know we'll get over it. So Bonnie Raitt also won for Song of the Year, which was crazy to see. I thought we were being punked for a second. No offense, she deserved it, absolutely. As a Harry fan, whose Harry Styles had the biggest song of 2022, that was like the one Grammy I was like, we have in the bag. As well as the lineup she was against to beat like Beyonce and Taylor Swift and Adele, like everyone was kind of shocked. Everyone was kind of like, hold on. But then it picked up more and we were like, wait, she does deserve this. Okay, period, Bonnie. That was crazy to see in real time. Throughout the night, the celebrities, I feel, were really, really, like, social with each other. Past year of award shows has been really like that. No one has either been able to see each other for a little while or been able to like really come in contact or have a reason to come in contact because these award shows are when they would come in contact. Literally, thank you, Lizzo, I love you. And speaking of Lizzo, Lizzo, I personally thought had the greatest performance of the Grammys. I have to watch it every time it comes on my timeline. Every time that Lizzo's Grammy performance comes, I have to sit there and watch and I cry every single time. And sometimes I'll sit there and then I'll watch it again and then cry even more. Some performances that I see that I will just watch back over and over and over again is definitely going to be joining that list. They also celebrated 50 years of hip hop, I believe, which was really cool. And I know my mom was really excited. She was actually watching the Grammys for this because she loves, like, this is her music. This is her vibe. This isn't my music and my vibe, but this is hers. But I did appreciate it. I thought it was really good. It was just so excellent and so beautiful, especially during Black History Month. Let's go. Like, come on. And going back to Lizzo, she also won a Grammy for Record of the Year, and she was the first Black woman to win since Whitney Houston won it for I Will Always Love You, and that is so
this little video of her like squealing with Beyonce is it makes me so happy. And finally, Beyonce broke the record for the most Grammys ever won with 32 Grammys. She also showed up a little late, which, girl, you're literally Queen Bee. Go for it. So when they announced that happened, she wasn't even there. But then they had a thing after once she arrived. It's just such a good Grammys. The biggest talk of the town, of course, everywhere he goes. The man of the hour, the man of my heart, the man of my life. The subject in everything, even when he did nothing wrong, and even when there is nothing going wrong, and when he's not a part of it. The talk of the town every single time, because the world is obsessed with him whether they like it or not. Harry Styles. And with that, we're gonna jump over to Lindsay with a Z to the Styles dance spot. I don't remember.
Should we just search romantic comedies on Netflix and then see what we find?
Every single one of you guys sucks for you. You wanna know why? Because you know who didn't lose nothing? This guy, right here. Hi guys, I'm Lindsay with the Z, and this is the Style Stand Spot, your one-stop spot for anything Harry Styles. Anything. I got it. I got him here, I got him there, I got him there, I got him everywhere, alright? This week, the Grammys happened. The Grammys went better than I had hoped. At least for me. Harry Styles was the talk of the freaking town with the Grammys. Even silly little things that people were upset and then would twist into big things that really didn't matter, because everything anyone does ever is now compared to Mr. Harry Styles. He is the standard, and Harry Styles pulled up to the Grammys with a jumpsuit. 250,000 Swarovski crystals on it. It took over 150 hours to make. It was made by Egon Lab in Paris, and it was technically by Gucci. And he looked absolutely incredible. He looked so good. He had to walk through the metal detector a couple times. I think it's because all the crystals were setting it off. He looked so good. He looked so good. And so many people are like, oh my God.
No, that's your internalized homophobia, babe. He slayed it. He killed that shit.
He also performed at the Grammys. He performed as it was, which I was really excited about, and I'm really, really proud of him. It was absolutely not his best performance, which really, really sucked to see, but a lot of it wasn't his fault. They were having some mic issues with his mic, as well as the entire turntable was turning the wrong way. They sat there and they worked with this turntable, which is kind of really hard to work on, to perfect this dance and perfect this show with it turning clockwise. And then the second that the Grammys performance started, it started turning the other way. And so all the dancers and everyone had to pull off their entire routine backwards with the whole entire like feel of the thing going. They absolutely killed it, did absolutely phenomenal. Harry obviously was nervous. He gets nervous in these type of environments, as well as he gets nervous when it comes to performing in front of really big things. He always has. He used to literally shake during What Makes You Beautiful, and that breaks my fucking heart. His voice cracked a little, like first note on As It Was, but then the rest, it was phenomenal. But you could tell that he was wigging a little bit. Really, really, really excited for him to get back on stage and perform in an environment that he is so better used to performing in. Also throughout the night, Harry Styles and Taylor Swift had a little chit chat, and I just needed to mention that. I couldn't live on without mentioning that because I love them so much. I owe my entire life to them, and to see them cool is so special to me because they are two sides of one sun, if that makes any sense. It does to me. Before the Grammy Awards started, Harry's House, the album, won the Grammy for Best Engineered Album, which I thought it was going to anyways. Walking in, his album already has one Grammy. Harry Styles also won the first Grammy Award given during the night, the Grammy for Pop Vocal Album, and J-Lo gave it to him. It was incredible. It was such a good start off the show. It was like, okay, first award, Harry Styles, let's go, like, come on. And then, just like a good old sandwich, start and end, the final award was given for Album of the Year, the biggest award of the night. And everything was snap by snap perfect. I still get butterflies
when I watch it. I cannot describe or recreate ever in my life the feeling that I had watching it. I'm just gonna play it for a second.
You can read it.
Harry Styles!
Throughout the Grammys, they had these super fans there discussing all the nominees for Album of the Year, and Harry's representative was Raina, this little old lady who I just loved so much. She's the homie. Like, I slay Raina. They were announcing that album. What you saw was all those super fans lined up, and Trevor Noah, the host for the night, came over to the super fan of the winner, and the second that he started and went over to Raina, I blacked out, I think. I knew. Like, she was just like us. She did this.
I love Bad Bunny also, but guess where he was last night? At Harry Styles' concert.
She is a Stan Report freaking legend, dude. And she did interviews and everything after the award show. She just kept saying how Harry was the only, like, star that came over to talk to the super fans, and he came over a couple times and, like, read her letter while they were there and just, you know, Harried it up. Like, you know, was the most genuinely best person he could possibly be. And he's always had his fans there. Whether he liked it or not, we were there. Because he was in a boy band. Like, his fans, everywhere he went, his fans were there. And so I think throughout the years, he's gotten this emotional, like, deep connection to his fans and the people that support him. The second that he ran on that stage and ran into that hug into Raina, like, his demeanor changed, like, shifted a little bit. And, like, he turned into, like, the Harry that I know. Instead of, like, nervous, anxious Harry and, like, to himself Harry that he kind of was all night, he instantly, like, just switched into it. He's like, ah! And it was so perfect. And then when he came over and started celebrating with his collaborators and Kid Harpoon and everyone, it was so special. And then after the award, they went back to the dressing room and the whole band was there, which is also really, really exciting. And especially when they're performing, to see the band and to see Mitch and Sarah and Pauly and not, like, all of them on that Grammy stage with him. Because I love that band almost as much as I love Harry. We've all been through it with them, especially Mitch and Sarah. This whole solo career of Harry's, they've been there for him and with him and with us as well. To see them not only on that Grammy stage, but to celebrate this Grammy's win with Harry is so special. It's so amazing. And even get Grammy awards, because Mitch especially has stuff for and written for and on that album. He has his credits. So, so awesome to see, and just, like, filled my heart so much. And it was really like seeing these people I'm so used to seeing, like, regular on the day to day with, like, in the circumstances that they're always in of, like, shows and meeting with fans and, like, in the Harryverse, and to see them now outside of that Harryverse is like seeing, like, your mom and, like, your whole family. Like, it literally feels like a family, and to see everyone so excited and so happy was so special to me. And they really, 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 really deserved all of it. And I hope every single one of them celebrated their freaking heart out, which he really, 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 I feel, needed, especially so to have that support system and that family around him when he won. Because when he was giving his acceptance speech on stage, people were yelling out and saying, get off the stage, Beyonce should have won, blah, 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 blah. Disgusting behavior, disrespectful behavior, no matter who it is. But, you know, they did it in 2009, so it was really, really nice to see, though, everyone that did, like, jump up and stand. And, like, Lizzo, she screamed, because they're best friends. She screamed, her was screaming. Taylor stood up and was so conscious, especially when the heckling started. I know she had 2009 flashbacks and was like, absolutely not on my watch. Not to my pal, not to my homie, not on my watch. Like, I know if someone went on that stage, she'd be there. She'd black out and go. Like, he also said, things like this don't happen to people like me very often, which is a piece of his thank you speech that he does every single show at tour. And I think the second that it rolled off his lips, I knew two things to be true. I knew he was so panicked and in shock that he just literally resulted back to the tour and just blacked out and was like, I already have something like this prepared, I'll just let it go. And two, I knew the second he said it, I was like, they're not gonna get it.
They're not gonna understand it. They're not going to get it. And of course, the world didn't get it, and everyone and their mom complained left and right. I get that part. I do. I truly get that part. But honey, whoa. And I'm so sorry for this little bit of ramble. But things like this don't happen to people like me very often. It's true. It's true. I don't remember the last time a 16-year-old who wanted to go on a singing show that grew up in the small town with no connections to Hollywood won album of the year. Or, you know, the like 5-6 years of One Direction where they were not only refused to take seriously as musicians in this world because of their teenage girl fan base, because they're not legitimate fan fucking sources. Bitch! I'm getting fired up. The sabotage that he has felt and the consistency of it, the whole Grammys and their reaction to twisting anything possible this kid could have done at all just because he beat Beyonce, which wasn't his fault, twisting it around to serve a narrative that one he doesn't serve. I could dive into the queer baiting thing alone. Just take away him being a decent human. Oh my god, Harry's a decent guy. I hate him. I hate him so much. I need to stop because I could talk about this for like a half an hour because that makes me mad. I've been fighting with people on Twitter left and right like nobody's business. My drafts have been doubled the past week. In the end, Beyonce and Harry Styles went to the same after party. Well, Harry got invited to Beyonce's after party and he had a little Grammy on his shoe and it was so cute on his little... What are they called? The Satellite Stompers. His little Satellite Stomper Grammy edition. I loved it. I just loved it. He looked so happy and just so well. And I'm just so happy he's not on social media. He has such an open, good support system around him. One Direction also... Well, I guess half of One Direction congratulated Harry. Niall and Liam congratulated Harry. Niall's was very cute. Liam was a little like, all right. Okay. Finally, Orville Peck and him got a little photo together at like the first after party like earlier in the night. It just reminded me of Harry Ween and that made me a little happy because they're just so cool. Both of them are so cool. This weekend, Harry Styles is performing at the Brits. I'm really, really excited because like I said before, last time he performed at the Brits, literally one of the best live performances he's ever performed. This is a much more comfortable environment, I feel, for him. He's a Brit in the Brits. He's much more comfortable there. So I'm really excited, especially after this Grammys and what happened with this Grammys. Also, I'm hoping for a sweep. It's gonna be between him and Adele, because they're the two golden Brits. They're the two kings and queens of Britain. So, we'll see what happens. I think that's all I have. See you guys next week. Thanks for watching the Harry Styles stand spot. Bye.
What did Harry and Lizzo sing when they were at Coachella and then again at the after party? Because it's probably their song and will make me want to vomit if I think about. That's right. I will survive. And I keep on turning. Closing story for you guys, of course, some Sims news. The Sims 4 just announced their new expansion pack, Growing Together, coming out March 16th. And if you pre-order, you get exclusive items. And there should be an infant update coming up before that. And I'm really, really excited for Growing Together. Like, really, like, stop thinking about it. Otherwise, I'm just gonna be mad that I don't have it right now. It's like a generations pack for The Sims, and it's all family gameplay. And I think that's it. Treat people with kindness. Look out for my sunglasses. Always be conscious of your environmental footprint. And bye, everybody.